Hello everyone! We are back once again with another episode of Kane and Rince Streams Steel Battalion. It's episode 15! We do episodes here in Kane and Rince and streaming and stuff. But yeah, just gotta shift this over a bit. So, where were we last week? What were we doing? We were doing stuff. We were trying to complete mission 6. We were very close. We come up with a technique as advised by the lovely chatter. Sabre! Welcome to the chat. There we are. And yeah, we did stuff. It was a time. I've got a little bit frustrated. Not going to deny it, but not to the point of real anger. You've seen me getting real angry. I put a mat down on where my pedals are, as advised by others to say. Try to stop it from slipping. It's on the carpet, you see, and the rubber pads don't really work on carpet. They just slide over them. So hopefully this mat will help. I don't know if it will. We shall see. But I am having difficulties. I'm sort of jabbing away at the pedals. They generally slide in under the desk. And when they do that, there's like this bar underneath my desk. And what happens is it gets caught underneath. And then it's permanently down. And it's all disaster, really. Anyway. Let's hit the main weapon button. I think the volume's a little bit loud. I might have been using... No, it's fine. So how are we all? It's mid-June, it's hot. We're watching the Euros 2020. They're fun, aren't they? Unless you're English, like me. Not so fun. Mind. Sorry, very topical. Sure, when you're watching this in the future, go, oh, yeah, that was a terrible game against Scotland. That was awful. Anyway, we're not here to talk about football. We're here to talk about Steel Battalion. As is tradition, we do like to indicate what all this is about, because sometimes we get new viewers in, new people coming in to watch the stream. Mood for mission 6 being cleared. Thank you, Sabre. I appreciate the confidence. Probably not earned, but never mind. Don't worry. On the left-hand side, we have gear stick. Goes from reverse up to fifth gear. I think twice in the last 15 or maybe 20 hours or so of playing, I've gone into fifth gear. I'm typically in fourth maximum, I've found. Managed to get prescription lenses for my Index this week. Nice! I've got prescription lenses for my PlayStation VR and my Quest 2. Highly recommended. If you wear glasses, you've got VR... get prescription lenses for your VR stuff. It's awesome. It stops hurting. It stops hurting. You take your glasses off, you put them on, and it's awesome. They are not cheap, though. They are not cheap. However, they are very much worth it if you can afford them. As I was saying, in the middle we have... Oh, sorry. Steering column over on the left. There we go. And viewing sort of thumbstick here. Then we have the systems toggles, as I call them. You flip them on when you get going and fire up. In the middle, we have the main sort of sub-interface sort of thing. This is for comms, special abilities, depending on what VT you're running. And these are all like for washing, the head thing. Fire extinguisher, chaff, which is very useful, especially in this mission I'm doing. Magazine change, and then change of weapon. So that's quite important, this central column. But then we have here on the right-hand side, we have the aiming stick. We have the eject button, which, as advised by Saber many, many, many months ago now, always have it open during play. Because that way, when you have to eject, you don't have to remove the cap and then press the eject. That takes waste valuable time, which is very dangerous. Then there's cockpit hatch and ignition start. Cockpit hatch light is now working. It wasn't working last week. It now is. Not sure what's going on with that. I've been told just to ignore it. It's perfectly fine. And then we have camera views and stuff like this down at the bottom here. So there it is. So as is tradition, going to do a free mission. I am not going to repeat mission 5 ever again, but I'm going to have a go at mission 4. And I'm going to do it a rookie, though. So we do mission 4. Let's do mission 4. This is the one where you have to take on the boss fight. Maybe a loose connection. Fishy, don't tell me that. If it's a loose connection, I'll go in. Because unlike most people, I don't shy away from a soldering iron. You probably don't know this about me, but you know, I've modified a Mega Drive to so it can play any region, and that required a lot of soldering. I've also done all, I've recapped Atari. Sega Master System, Amigas. I'm going to recap a Texas Instruments 99/4A pretty soon because the video is not working properly. Trust me, if you say it's a loose connection, I'll go in there with a soldering iron. I will. You don't want me to do that, Fishy. Right. I will go in there. Right. Because I don't care. I don't care. I'm not one of those people who shy away from soldering irons. I'm pretty adept at them. So let's go in this. Gonna go in the prominence for this. Let's do this. But I think you're right. It probably is a loose connection. So let's do this. So this is always open up the stream with a practice session. So because I do not stream this game during the week or between streams. I do not do that. Play the game. I could. But I just think it's a bit dishonest on the part of the stream. The whole point of the stream is that you watch me experiencing the game in real time rather than in gaps. So, see, look, the cockpit hatch light is working now. Yeah, it could be a very easy job for you then. Just be careful with the screws as they are very easy to get them stuck if not handled carefully. Thank you for the tip. Now, I'm in the middle of recapping a SNES or SNES. But the surface mount, I can't stand surface mount caps. Hate them. Pain in the bum. But anyway, let's fire this up. Go! Come on, I'm in gear. Wow, this thing's slow. Boom. There you go. Oops. Here we go. Let's. Do we go to override again, or maybe not? It's been a while since I've done this mission. I don't have much. Yeah. Damn it, I'm really messing up here. He's gone. He's blown up. I'm gonna go. Oh, come on, blow up. This goes, I can go. Got a plan how I'm going to get out of this mess because I've got myself in a bit of a mess. Could be our turn. Slowly swing round. I don't know what he's doing. Swing round. I'll just... Here he is. Come on.
Wagon Master, this is Oscar 3.
Gonna call him for reinforcements.
This is Wagon Master. Oscar 3, what is it?
This is Oscar 3, requesting supplies. Send supply chopper ASAP.
This is Wagon Master. Roger that. The supply chopper is on its way.
I'm just gonna wait for the chopper here. Hopefully it's going to survive. Here it comes. Have they been taken out?
This is Wagon Master. Do you read? Over.
That's BS right there. Yeah, I know.
Oscar 3 here. I read you. Over.
Oscar 3, the supply chopper has been hit and gone down. Unfortunately, it looks like we can't resupply you this time around.
I'm gonna ask again.
Wagon Master, this is Oscar 3. Do you copy?
This is so annoying. This is so rude.
Oscar 3, what is it?
Come on.
This is Oscar 3, requesting supplies. Send supply chopper ASAP.
This is Wagon Master. Roger that. The supply chopper is on its way.
I'm not gonna speak too soon, although I'm about to. I think the mat's working because it's not slid, so that's pretty good. But we shall see. Here comes the chopper. Hopefully, I don't shoot it down this time. Here it comes. So ever since I've got advice. Fantastic advice from chat, by the way. I'm definitely treating this as like a health potion with some ammo. We talked about this last week. There seemed to be some appreciation that this is a valid sort of description. Just move. Thank you. I realise I've got a foot fix on me. Are they trying to... Probably going to hit a building again. No, I'm not. I'm alright. I'm good. Yeah, I am. Oh, that's the one thing that does annoy me about this game is the constant hit and the clipping of... it's not good. Oh, what am I doing? Slowing down. Blimey. Okay. Oh, stop. Yep, central. Right, so this is where it gets tricky. How to make an official Steel Battalion health potion. One, put in bullets, any put in gasoline, any blend 5. Enjoy it, yes! Yeah, it's definitely like a health potion. Welcome to the chat, everyone. Welcome to the stream. This is all good stuff. Okay, right. I'm going to do that. Son of a bitch. Well, almost went into the drink then. Oh, there it goes. You're definitely getting better. 3 health points left this time. Thank you. Yeah, I noticed that. I was a bit hesitant to play fourth mission because nemesis is the right word. But because I did get really stuck on it, really stuck. But I wanted to do it for 2 reasons. I wanted to get better at dodging bullets, and I think I'm getting slightly better at it. You're right, I almost went straight into the water then by dodging that stuff. But also I wanted to test this mat out because you really do need to jab and push and move, and it's really working very well. I think the pedal's a little bit too close though. I'm just going to move it just a little bit. But yeah, that's better. Yeah, that's better. That's more comfortable. The mat seems to be working. So thanks, chat. You came through again. You were right. So I'm going to go back. So, campaign. Let's have a look. Listed pilots. Go, go, go. We've been through all this already. We all know what we need to do. Yeah. It's fine. Right. Supply account. I seem to remember I did need one. I do remember that. So these things off. Neutral. Good. That's all good. Reinforcements. I do need one, sadly. Prominent, yes. And I'll get one supply. Go. Let's go. Let us go. Let's do this thing. You may notice I'm wearing my Elite t-shirt again. There's reasons for that. I'm going to be starting playing Elite Dangerous. See, look, this is working again. Look, the button's working. There is something to... I don't know. I reckon you're right. It's a loose connection, which is really annoying. I had to repair my screwdriver charger recently because it had a loose connection. Or the solder had gone for some reason. Don't know why. Anyway, that's not important. What is important is my ability to do this mission. Now, the first part is we follow the numpties. That's what I call my comrades in arms. The numpties, because they are profoundly stupid. I mean, you think I can't pilot a VT. You should see this lot. I mean, I would actually, you know, I've already filed a formal complaint against both of them because I blame them for their for a failure so far. So I think that's fair. I'm not going to blame, you know, myself. It's not, you know, why is it all up to me? These are commissioned officers as well. These are pilots. But no, it's all my fault. It all comes down to me. What's that about? We have contact. Pour it in. Okay, it's full of the numpties. So yeah, I'm going to start with playing Elite Dangerous again. Because I've always liked that game, but it's just so dense. It's so dense. But yeah, I've always wanted to... Let's just go a little bit slower. Nope. They're freaking out because they've got a contact. And look at them. Honestly, I have grounds to complain with these two. They are just... They're dangerous. Oh, what's he doing now? Right. Nope. He's in the way. Look, line of fire. Right, here we go. Okay, here we go. I've got a lock on him, but I can't actually get... I don't mind following these two, I really don't. I hate pressing enter too early. Oh well. Can happen. I know what it feels like. Okay. Oh, come on. I'm getting damaged by running into my teammates here. I'm just gonna go. Come on. I want a timer here. Come on, people. Zoom in around. Okay, we gotta have to swing round a bit. Drop to one, start and swing, cut and turn without falling over. I did fall over last week. Very angry about that. Wasn't good. What a lock. Save. No, oh, damn it. No, we damn it. No, this is not good. Not good, not good. Stupid arm, get over here. No. Oh, really? Oh, no. Oh, come on. That was a waste. I got really badly damaged. And because I couldn't swing round. Right, I'm going to have to call. This is wasteful.
Wagon Master, this is Oscar 3. Do you copy?
This is Wagon Master. Oscar 3, what is it?
This is Oscar 3, requesting supplies. Send supply chopper ASAP.
This is Wagon Master. Roger that. The supply chopper is on its way.
Yeah, supply chopper is on its way, which I didn't want to do this early in the mission. But I have to, apparently. Because this really messed up that engagement. Really messed it up. Never mind. Never mind. Where's the chopper? What's it coming in from there for? Very strange. What I'm finding is like swinging the gun around to aim at the oh, that's right, you gotta go down here, haven't we? Honestly, they are just the worst, aren't they? I mean, there's easier ways to get round there rather than trying to do a side step. It's absurd. Yeah, I saw that come in. Okay, they're engaged then. That's fine. I mean, at least they're keeping them distracted. I can't walk through them, everyone. I mean, they're just shooting at walls now. One of them's toppled over, I think. Come on, you can do this. Either you get blown up or they do. I can't walk through them. No, they're just shooting at cliff sides. Look. Just numpties. Come on. No? Limey. Look at this. Look, I can give. Right, that's it. I'm done with these two. That's just hilarious. No, I don't feel any vengeance that I need to. Oh, you miserable little. Stop it. Just go. Right, I'm going to just rush ahead. Is it? I remember now. I can always put them down. It doesn't feel right to put them down. I don't remember where it is. Is it left or right? Oh, it's right. It's around here. I've got to take this one out. It makes sense. It's the most guarded valley. Let's take this one out. Ooh. A good idea to start in second gear, is it? Right, now I remember from last week. I hug this left cliff face. A read of chat minute, but I need to do this very carefully. I hug this left cliff face, I then swing round. I'm gonna leave the map zoomed out a little bit so I can do this properly. And then I can do like a drive by, so when they come out they're behind me, so I can then run. And I go run all the way along there, and then I have to hang. I'm going that way. I have to go left, I think, or right. I'm going to get it right now. Right, I'm going to see if I can lock on to the target. There they are. Are they getting closer or not? I'd rather gauge them now before the gates open and all hell breaks loose. They're getting closer, I think. Yeah, they are. Good. They don't think I'm going to get them, let them get closer. Really appreciate it. I've only got 5 minutes left, but the clock gets reset. Stick that on. Boom. Bingo. Right. This is it, everyone. Here we go. I don't hold out much hope. I've got the comms channel on the main. So when they start yelling at me, I can immediately I've got chaff ready as well. Pop a override and go into fifth.
Oscar 3, this is Argus. Do you copy? Over.
Oscar 3 here. I read you, Argus. Over.
This is Argus. We have verified the transport visuals as the enemy's facility entrance. Well done. Pull out.
I copy. Oscar 3.
Damn it! I knew it was gonna do it. I can't turn. I can't turn fast. That's why I always fail in this, because I can't. I can go fast for straight line, but I have to slow down to turn. I have to, otherwise I will fall over, as you saw. So, yeah, I just recommend not staying in the lower gears, but how else am I supposed to? Oh, I see, I just sort of. So you think I'll just stay in fifth gear? I mean, it's fine. I'm okay with doing that. But yeah, that's the big problem with this mission, is that you've got to, A, remember to know where to go. Yep. Need supplies. Yep. Probably going to be the penultimate one. But let's just do this. We'll keep on going, as I always do. I will keep trucking. That's how I play this game. You know. So you stay in the upper gear. We also, when you turn, you can dodge periodically, and that will reset your balance. Yes, I'm aware of that. But you have to time it. There's a very small window to actually be able to do that. I've done it a couple of times, but not, you know. The button's working. Don't get it. I can do this. There we go. Oops. If you do it while you aren't falling state, reset how close you are to getting that falling state. Right. Think of falling like a bar that fills up the more you turn. Okay. Gonna switch frequencies to the Wagon Master now. So, if you haven't noticed, on the right-hand side there, there's like little radio things that pop out depending on what frequency I'm going on. So, it's very useful to know. The manual doesn't tell you that. You just got to figure it out for yourself, which is great. Going to stick with the strategy of following the numpties. That's fine. Uh-oh. Ranging. That's a hit. That's not a hit. Oh, it is. There you go. Strike one. Strike one for the good guys, apparently. No, this strafing reminds me of Quake. That was the first game I actually understood the value of strafing. Not Doom. I know, right? Weird. But, yeah, Quake was the game that, like, oh, yeah. Circle strafing is a thing. Thing. Yeah, I think it's to do with proximity of it. So I think it isn't. Okay, you made me look at it while being close enough. That's right. I think you're right because you need to see it. It does make sense that the game will require you to do that. But yeah. So just to be clear, Line of Contact, which is the multiplayer version of this game, it supports widescreen, doesn't it? Because as much as I enjoy 4x3, I really want to get back to widescreen. Can you confirm that? Oh, very good. Because I'm looking at an LCD widescreen. It's a really old one. It's like from 2006, I think. Yeah, it's really old. Wow. There you go. I'm going to say this, but I'm actually now reached a point where I'm better at this than I am or was at MechWarrior 2. Yeah. Granted, I haven't played that game in over 20 years, but I got pretty good at it. But I think I'm reaching a point where my skill level is almost a par with that because I got really into it. It's one of the early Windows 95 games. So I know it's a very different game, but there is some similarities because you are driving a very large robot. Let's zoom out a bit. Okay, we've got to go over to the right where most of the mechs are. I'm going to leave the numpties behind now because they were annoying last time. And I'm actually going to use them as like a beacon for where I should be going when I get out of here. Just fine. Let's go that way. But yes, I did like MechWarrior 2. Bonkers game. From a bonkers universe. I'm gonna shoot at these. Please get over there. No, that's too distant. Whoa, what happened there? Oh no. Uh-oh. Zoom out again. Oh, that's that one. Yeah, that's that one. Uh-oh. Here we go! If you dodge forward, sometimes you can force it to go through if the thing blocking you is close enough to the edge. Interesting to know. One of my favourite mech games, or big robot games, on the Xbox, the original Xbox, was Mech Assault. It was a very silly game, but it was one of the earliest Xbox Live games ever released. I think it was one of the first. And I remember playing that for hours online because back then the community was very small, tiny compared to what it is now. And the amount of setup you had to have, because there was no Wi-Fi or anything, it just had an Ethernet, or Ethernet, however you pronounce it. I think it's Ethernet, actually, Chris. Yes, it is. But anyway. Yeah. That kind of like... the effort required to get online with those back in 2002, was quite a lot compared to what it is now. It's relatively easy now. So the barrier of entry was quite high, which meant, you know, the community was relatively small, etc., etc. I had a good time with it. It was really good fun. Good game. I actually streamed it for Kane & Rince, I think, about maybe 2 years ago now. I'm not going to stream it again. It hasn't aged well as a game, I'm afraid. It did release a sequel. It wasn't very good. So right, I'm going to let this fella come in. And if I can do better, so I'm just reading chat. Do liking the chat, getting a little bit confused. Yeah, that's fine. Good stuff. Oh, let's dodge out the way, make sure. I'm not looking at the door, I'm making sure I don't look at the door. I'm going to put this on, so... Oh, nice! There you go. Right, flick that off, so I don't need that. So have I got the iron? Yeah, here we go. Right, so I'm going to switch to Commander. Gonna take a drink, you know, because kind of wound myself up. Here we go. Now, chat's telling me to put it straight into fifth gear. I'm gonna believe them. So, you know, in fifth gear. It goes against everything I believe, but there it is. I've trusted them from now, and they've been great. So here we go.
Oscar 3, this is Argus. Do you copy?
Oscar 3 here. I read you, Argus. Over.
This is Argus. We have verified the transport visuals of the enemy's facility entrance. Well done. Pull out.
I copy. Oscar 3.
Oh, are you kidding me? You stupid idiots! Yes! I did notice the friendly VT actually messed it up for me. They massively messed it up for me. I was livid. But I freaking did it, everyone! Did it! Oh! What a game! What a game! Oh, yes! Yes! Now for the fun mission! Oh, God, please don't. I'm actually going to call the stream here. I'm going to do that. Expeditionary Force Stuff Unit, reconfirmed facility to a weapons factory. Giving much emphasis on the strategic value of the enemy's facility, the Expeditionary Force dispatched the 7th Special Panzer Division to Nanyang Valley. The 34th Special Panzer Battalion, under the command of the division, was ordered to take control of the factory installation. Oh, really? No. No, we're not doing this. Chat, please tell me this is not. No, don't. No. No, please. No. Not this. No. Oh, God. We're going to read the mission briefing. We're going to read the mission briefing, but I'm not streaming it. I'm not attempting it. I'm too much on a high. Okay. The fact that I managed to find it. That was a... mission briefing. It's absurd. Take control over the VT testing facility located in the lowest level of the military factory. Our reconnaissance activity revealed that the facility in Yangyang Valley is an important enemy weapons factory. Today, at 2200 hours, our battalion will penetrate the weapons factory with all four of our VTs in an effort to gain military control over the facility. Reconnaissance has also confirmed that there is a mercenary group called Jalalax who are working with normal VT troops. In some ways, the mercenary group could prove to be more troublesome than our normal enemies we're used to, so be very cautious. Also, this will be our first night fight. All of you should read the night scope section of the manual carefully. That's the night scope button right here. There you go. Jalalax are the same things chasing you from before. Oh, right. I'm going to check something, because normally when you complete a mission, you get more mechs. Or VTs. Sorry, VTs. That's mechs is another franchise. I'm going to turn all this off. Seriously, we are not. Not doing this. I can't. I'm too on the high at the moment. I've done it. I've done mission 6. Come on. Reinforcements. Let's have a look. Do I get any more? Let's have a look. We know that one. Don't think there are any new ones. No. No, sad face. Okay. And back to title. Here you go. Back to title. And saved. You gain VTs from destroying ones that you find, or they just give you new ones, but you know it comes because there's a cutscene. That's true. That you get a new VT, cutscene, VT. That was fantastic. Thanks very much for chat, for the tips and the encouragement. It's always good. But yeah, that was awesome. Really, really enjoying it now. Really getting into it. It's only been playing for about 20 hours. It makes sense now, but it's been gaps every week. This is quite a thing. I'm happy that I am doing this. There are times when I'm not. During this session, I got rather angry and frustrated, but that's the whole point. The fact that this light's coming back on, that's nice. That was nice. Although, you know, I might have to go in there with a soldering iron and see what's going on. But let's end the stream by closing the lid. And we'll be back. Oh, actually, are we back next week? I may not be, because I'm actually out next week. I might delay it a day. Might do a Sunday stream. I might do that. But tomorrow, we are streaming again, Kane and Rince, but it's our variety show, which means we do a variety of games. And that is Stonefly. We're streaming Stonefly. It's a game come out about a month ago. So it's a very, very young game. It's very, very good as well. So, yeah, if you want to stick around for that. It's a very different game. It's actually it's an action adventure, but non-violent. No one gets hurt. Aw, nice. Anyway, thank you very much for watching this stream. We'll be back next week, probably Sunday, not Saturday. And but until then, goodbye.